Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy. Hey guys, look, thank y'all for getting this channel to where it is. So today's video, quick, short, straight to the point. With blueprints and home run circuits, you may ask, how do you know what wire to put on what circuit breaker? Or how do you know the lights that are in one room, how do you know what circuit breaker they're gonna be on? Or the outlets, how do you know what circuit breaker they're gonna be on? Well look, it's very simple. There's a process to doing the install work, and there's another process to the project management side of the work, you know, or the master electrician side of the work, or the journeyman electrician side of the work, whether you're gonna be a foreman or a superintendent, blueprint reading is gonna be essential. Okay guys, look, so if you see, these are my lights. These are the rooms. Okay? So, if we trace this back to where it ends, or let's go back this way. If we trace it back this way, we'll see an arrow right there. That arrow means home run. And you see that one? That means circuit one. Okay, so let's go down here to the panel schedule. We'll find circuit one, lighting. Simple as that. Now, what I've been doing, I've been making my own notes. I kind of rearranged some of the circuits on here because I didn't like how the engineer placed some of the circuits. So I kind of made some notes and a few changes, which is fine, totally fine. There's nothing wrong with that. As long as it's still within code, we should be fine. So now, the next part of this equation, when you run all your MC cable throughout the building, how do you know which MC cable is number one? Okay, so look, simple. I'm gonna use some duct tape. And what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna write circuit one. So that will allow me or any of the men that I have in here working to identify which circuit is which. And they can easily come over here and identify circuit one is us as lighting. Circuit two, convenience receptacle, convenience outlet. Or we come over here to this side, circuit 12 and 10. Circuit 12 is gonna be the washer, and circuit 10 is gonna be, I'm sorry. Circuit two is gonna be the washer, and circuit four and circuit six is gonna be the dryer. So for our lighting, we're gonna write circuit one on this duct tape. Circuit CKT one. Circuit one. Now I'm gonna flip the tape over and write it on this side. Circuit one. Okay. Now, like I said, anybody that's working with me, if I'm not here and they need to identify what circuit goes where, or what circuit goes to what box, all they have to do is come over here to this tape. Look at the tape. And you can easily see that says circuit one on both sides, circuit one. So guys, look, this electrical is not difficult. There's just a lot of different things you have to learn and retain, and then you have to do it again. Then you have to do it again. Then you have to do it again. And then you have to do it again. So doing this one time or two times, you know, or maybe for 2 or 3 years, there's some things you will forget along the way. So you have to do it again. Then you have to do it again. Just like when I passed my journeyman electrician test, there's some things I forgot that I have to go back and revisit because I haven't done it or I haven't used that particular part of the code maybe 10 years. So guys, look, blueprint reading is not difficult. For you guys that are still watching this video right now, thank you. But please hit the like button for the algorithm and hit that subscribe button to help the channel grow. See y'all, let's get back to the video. What helped me out learning blueprint reading was when I was like a third or fourth year apprentice, I would ask my foreman or I would ask my superintendent, hey, do you have any blueprints that you're throwing away that I can take home and just study? Because every few months, they'll come out with a new revised set of blueprints, a new revised set of drawings. So those old drawings from 6 months ago are gonna be outdated. They're gonna come out with a new revised set that they're gonna throw away. So I would just go to my foreman, my superintendent, hey, you got some blueprints you're gonna be throwing away? Yeah, can I take them home? Yeah, just take them home. That's how I got good at reading blueprints. I didn't go to a blueprint reading school. I didn't take online classes. I just took blueprints home and started studying them on my own. That's how I got good at reading blueprints. So guys, look, I'm gonna wrap this video up right here. Thank y'all for watching. We'll see you next time back at United Tradesman Academy.